Hello. In today's lecture, we focus on the use of mass balances. Mass balances play an important role in the design and operation of many industrial installations. In many plants, raw materials are converted into products. To save material, energy, and money, this is done in the most efficient way. Nowadays, sustainable operation is required for the sake of future generations. Balances play a crucial role here. What is it, a mass balance? We are going to answer this question via the following example. Suppose we have a reactor with a process in which methanol, CH3OH, is one of the components which enters and leaves the reactor. We measure the mass of methanol flowing in and out of the reactor. In this example, we take that more methanol is flowing in than out. What is the reason for this difference? We could think of methanol is produced in the process, or methanol is chemically converted into other products, or there is a methanol leak. Leaking would mean that there is another outflow of methanol. We could measure that as well and calculate if the two outflows together are now the same as the inflow. In this example, we take that there is no leak and that more methanol is flowing into the reactor than is coming out. We have now two options. One, methanol stays behind in the reactor. Or two, methanol is converted into something else inside the reactor. In this example, we take that methanol accumulates in the reactor by absorption on an impurity which stays in the reactor. If we generalize this example of methanol to any material or compound, the mass balance of a certain material in a system can be written as accumulation equals inflow minus outflow plus production minus consumption. Accumulation means that the material can pile up in the reactor. The mass balance states that this is due to an imbalance between the flows and production. Usually, we combine the last two terms, production minus consumption, into a total production, which may thus be negative. It is convenient to even further shorten our notation and write ACK is in minus out plus production. Let's review the terms one by one. Inflow is the amount of material entering the system. Outflow is the amount of material leaving the system. Production is the amount of material that is chemically produced from another compound in the system. Consumption is the amount of material which is chemically converted into other compounds in the system. And finally, accumulation is the change in the amount of material in the system as a function of time. This general balance can be applied to any material entering or leaving a certain volume. It can be applied to small scales, like a cell, to a reactor vessel, or to a complete industrial plant. Another example of a balance is a population balance. We will illustrate this by looking at the population, that is the number of people in a country. Each year, 100,000 people enter the country. 30,000 leave the country each year. 170,000 babies are born, and 140,000 people pass away. This balance shows that each year, the population of this country grows with 100,000 people. As said before, a balance can be applied to all kinds of processes. For instance, take a bottle or glass of wine that is left open too long. The ethanol, C2H5OH, in the wine is oxidized into acetic acid, CH3COOH. In this lecture, we will analyze a process with a continuous in and outflow of components. ethanol flows in and out of the vessel. At the same time, oxygen flows into and out of the vessel, while in the reactor the ethanol is converted into acetic acid and water. The sketch shows the general picture of the in and out flows as well as the production. We will change our notation so that it better reflects the flows. You see that the mass flow rate of ethanol is indicated by phi sub me, comma in and phi sub me, comma out. Both these flows have units kilogram ethanol per second. They indicate how many kilograms ethanol in a second enter or leave the reactor. The subscript me denote m for mass and e for ethanol. We use this to indicate that it's a mass flow of ethanol. The mass flow rates of oxygen are similarly written as phi sub mo in and phi sub mo out. And the mass flow rate of the produced acetic acid and water by phi sub ma out and phi sub mw out, we write them as outflows as both leave the reactor. Now we can set up a mass balance of one species of the process, for example, ethanol. Again, we write accumulation equals inflow minus outflow plus production minus consumption. Applying this to ethanol gives us the following balance equation. We see a new way of writing. On the right-hand side, we use the symbol R sub E for the amount of ethanol that reacts with oxygen to acid. Further, we see on the left-hand side that we have written the accumulation term in a specific mathematical form, ddt of m sub e. This denotes in a formal mathematical way that the mass of ethanol inside the reactor is changing over time. Check out one of the glass plate examples where we show how we mathematically do this. Summarizing, we can say that setting up a balance is indeed a kind of bookkeeping. You can apply it to people, but also to certain chemical species, like ethanol in a process. That's all for this lecture. Please make the exercises, always starting with a sketch of your problem. Good luck and see you at the next lecture.